control of people. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Why David was grateful to God? Because he saw that the Lord removed him from the bush as a shepherd. He was anointed as someone, as a psalmist, from a psalmist to a king. The process came from God himself. And today, I've come to prophesy to your life. The process of God has come, and you be thankful today. As you are crossing to 2020, you live in the speedy anointing, and the divine speed will move with you. As you are thanking God today, there is nothing that will shake you. And listen to me. You will not cross over to 2020 with a leftover. I say again, you will not cross over to 2020 with leftover. But now hear this. The Lord says, I will give you even the leftovers to share with others. So now, you cross with the Lord. And then in January, the blessing from the Lord is not a leftover. It's a carryover. So if you are an option to people in 2019, 2020, you'll be the solution. There are people who took you as an option, but 2020, they are going to see you as a solution. The Bible says, you are more than a conqueror. And then the Bible says again, it fills your cup and it runs all. So you will not cross over with a leftover. Says the prophet reached in front of the father, who is Jesse, coming from a tribe of the king Christ, going to anoint a king. Confusion. And then there was a woman who had a problem with blood, of blood, and then she met someone with blood. She had a problem of, let me tell you, the people who used of as a pretext. Next year, they will use if as a context. Listen to me. I'm not a teacher. The teacher is here. If Pastor Danny came to Lusaka for me, I was going to be blessed. Lazarus, if Christ was, if you can, your friend was not going to die. That is negativity. Because of you, Christ, you have come. And you have called him. He's alive. Let's go. You understand that? People who used you in a context, in a pretext, now they will take you in a context. There will never be a word that will start with a pretext. It starts with a context. This year, 2020, Priscilla Kufekisa, you are blessed. That's all. Let me tell you, the neighbors who looked at you and said there is nothing good coming from you, those are the same neighbors who come and knock and ask if you are around. Being available and being around is the same way. It's just different words. Around and available. Jesus Christ said, I'll be with you. The devil also says, he's roving around. But the Lord says, I'll be with you. So no matter whatever the enemy said is about upon your life, but he says, I'm with you. So if you are around me, I don't care. You are around the area, I don't care. What I know is with me. So when you start thanking him, don't look for things that you start remembering. The first thing, remember, you never fought for you to have a child. You never went to a witch doctor to have a child. So don't pray. pray to say, no, Father, I remember my mother gave me, told me. Just say, God, I thank you for my child who will grow until I am not there. Father, I thank, let me tell, listen to me. Especially to women. Your brother-in-law, your sister-in-law fight you in your marriage. When, are we live on Facebook?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let them listen to what I'll say. When your husband came to you and said, I love you, they were not there. But when they start fighting you, you start crying. Even when they are fighting you, you are always away from them. So let them fight their own battles, because for the battle is for the Lord.
That's it.
The battle is for the Lord. So you are not there when they were not there when the man wanted you. And then you are not there when they are fighting you. Which means the person who takes charge of the battle is God himself.
Amen.
So you just appreciate him when the battle is starting.
Amen.
Until the end, you not know the end. But you discover that God has fought the battle.
Amen.
Stop wondering. It's time to thank him.
Amen.
Stop wondering. It's time to do what? To thank him. David said, great is the Lord. He's not saying devil is the great. Great is the Lord. You took your child to primary school, nursery, and everything. After school, university. It's not time for you to wonder or worry. The Bible says you are a wonder. A wonder can move at any time, at any place. So stop wondering. You need God in yourself. And today we are not prophesying. The prophecy is you thanking God for what he has done. From January to December, 29th of December 2019. Those who are born in 2000, they've graduated to 20 years. They are now matured. You can leave your parents' house, go and look for a job.
Hey!
Don't cry. You come and testify. Hallelujah! Let's pray. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We are not here because of ourselves. We are here, Jehovah, because of you. Our Father, we appreciate you. We lift up our hands in appreciation, Jehovah. Because you are great. You are above all. There is no one like you, Jehovah. You gave us, Jehovah, this life. Father, not for our glory, but to your glory. We return everything to you, Jehovah. Mwelesa tuami totena, tuami sumbula, tuami imia, tuami tatakula, shifwe, shimwilili, kape kape, mankangala, mwine kulumbwa, we mwine wafionse, tuaku totena. Father, we give you praise for this day. As we have come to the end of the year, Jehovah, we give you thanks. We appreciate you, Jehovah. We say thank you for all the members of Fresh Aroma. We thank you, Jehovah, for the life of our mother, Prophetess Mwaka. Our father, Apostle Darius, Jehovah. They are the overseers of this ministry. We thank you, Jehovah, because they are the greatest leaders, Jehovah, in our lives. The pioneers of our faith. We thank you, Jehovah, for they passed the baton, Jehovah, to us. Jehovah, and we appreciate you. We say thank you for all the leaders of Fresh Aroma. From the secretary, Father, everyone, the protocols, the singers, we say thank you for Pastor Danny, Jehovah Lord, for his ministry that has added, Jehovah, value, Jehovah Lord, to our worship team and the advancing of your work. We say thank you, Jehovah Lord, to the entire campus of Fresh Aroma. We thank you for the intercessors of this ministry. Jehovah, we thank you for the students of Fresh Aroma. We thank you for everything that you have done. We say thank you for the Kids Voice Africa, for the administration in this place. We thank you for all the visitors that you have brought to Fresh Aroma. We thank you for distinguished distinguished women. That heart is being led by Prophet Smwaka, our mother. We thank you, for you are the Father. You have made us giants. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. And we say amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's sit. Let's take our wonderful seats. Hallelujah. It determines, or it determines the number of the stars. It gives all. It gives all of them their names. Great is our Lord and abundant in power. His understanding is beyond. The Lord lifts up the humble and he casts the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. When you are ungrateful, God will cast you to the ground. Hallelujah. When you are not grateful to him, God will do what? He will cast you to the ground because you are not humble. You can't say thank you when you are not humble. That is wickedness. Amen. Hallelujah. Thanksgiving that you are not ready, that is not thanksgiving. It's wickedness. Hallelujah. I would like to ask one here. That's one person. From January to December, can you tell me how much you have paid to Lusaka Council to bring oxygen in your house? Just oxygen for you. You can answer me if you're ready, Esther. How much have you paid for your oxygen? Zero. Why are you alive? Where are you getting the oxygen? Who is your source? How do you know? You're not speaking. You're speaking in English. Hallelujah. Alice, how much are you paying for your oxygen? One career. You are here. How much have you paid for your oxygen from December 1st to 29th? Nothing. And then everyone says, Savior, the man who saved has come to worship you. Hallelujah. From December 1st to today, Pastor, no money has been paid by any of the members in the world for their oxygen. But remember that there are people in the hospital using the same oxygen and paying. And then someone, when you are on the oxygen, it's the doctor's choice to put you or not. When they say this case is very hard, they will put you there. And then when they have a lot of people, they look at you and say, ah, will you? Nah, you can't just stand 6 months with oxygen and there's no improvement. You are gone. Hallelujah. Who is deciding? Who is the source? Who is sourcing for the oxygen in the hospital? Huh? Basende Chimpompo, they put the oxygen there. Who is the source of that oxygen? Huh? It's God, huh? Through who? So who is deciding?
God.
So when you are thanking God, don't look at the process. Look at the source.
That's it.
No, I got married because someone connected me to that man. Not at all. Oh, not at all. Who improved? Not at all. The only source I know in this blessing is God.
That's it.
You got me a job. Yes, I appreciate. No, when you get paid, you have to give me 10% challenge sticker. They used to call us in that way. No, when especially my teachers. Someone connects you to get a job. Teachers, nurses, it happens. You get a job, you are working. That's the first salary
the person who connected you, if it's a salary 5,000 or maybe 6,000, 3,000.
Half.
Mama, I need my share because I connected you. You become a slave to that source. Manasseh is worse. Especially for, sorry, I'll just mention, I have nurses, I have teachers in this place. For a transfer, to say, no, we have to transfer, I saw it to my sister-in-law. The salary, mistakes, and whatever, no, you get yours, you get mine, and since your mine is bigger, so I'll send you the top up. And then the person gets away. Because the source is the human being. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. But when the source is God, there is nothing that you can fight with. Mm-hmm. It's just to go straight to the point and thank God. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We are going to open Psalms 147 from verse 1 to 8. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we there? And let's rise up so that we can read the word of God. Are we there? Uh-huh. Psalms 147. And then also we read Psalms 69. Verse 30. I will praise the name of the Lord with a song. I will magnify him with thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Psalms 30. Psalms 69, verse 30. Sorry. 69, verse 30. Are we there? Psalm 69, we start from Psalm 69 and then we'll go to Psalms 147, verse 1 to 7. Psalm 69, verse 30. Are we there?
Yes.
Okay, one can read for us.
Psalm 69, verse 30.
Amen.
The Bible reads,
amen.
I will praise the name of God with a song.
Uh-huh.
And will magnify him with thanksgiving.
Just there. I will magnify him with thanksgiving. Hallelujah. First of all, I will praise him. And then after praising him, I will magnify him with thanksgiving. And then 147, the Bible says, verse 1, Psalms 147. Can we read?
Can the Lord, word of the Lord says,
amen.
Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
How good to sing praises to our God.
Mm-hmm.
How delightful and how fitting.
Mm-hmm. Go on.
The Lord is rebuilding Jerusalem,
mm-hmm,
and bringing the exiles back to Israel.
Mm-hmm.
He heals the brokenhearted,
mm-hmm,
and bandages their wounds.
Mm-hmm.
He counts the stars,
mm-hmm,
and calls them all by name.
Mm-hmm. And then,
how great is our Lord?
Mm-hmm.
His power is absolute.
Mm-hmm.
His understanding is beyond comprehension.
Yes. Go on.
The Lord supports the humble,
mm-hmm,
but he brings the wicked down into the dust.
Seven.
Sing out your thanks to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Sing praises to our God with our heart.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's clap for the word of God. Let's take our seats. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I can't hear you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I will praise the Lord with a song. And the Bible says, the Lord will give me a new song.
That's it.
Your sufferings, your problems, your struggles have come to an end. Because this is the time that you have to sing a new song for the Lord. Praising and worshiping are two different things.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
To worship, you bow. Hallelujah. To worship in Hebrew, it's to prosuche. Hallelujah. You prostrate in front of the Lord. Prosuche. Hallelujah. Amen. To praise is to lift. Hallelujah. You are lifting. Are we together? You are bowing down to the Lord. You bow down to the Lord. It's a simple way of worshiping Him. You take your heart to Him. You pour down everything to Him. You lift Him. You humble yourself. You can't worship. You are standing looking at Him. He's also standing. He's also sitting looking at you. You have to bow. You prostrate to Him. You prosuche to Him. You call Him Abba. That is why in Israel it's called Abba. Because He's the center. He's sitting on the throne of glory. The Bible says, the earth is where He's putting His feet. And then the highest heavens is where He's sitting. That's where His throne is. Some of us, we are waiting to say, when I die, upon judgment, that's when I'll go to heaven. But when you worship Him in truth and in the spirit, you meet Him. You don't need to go to heaven when you die. Just worship Him in truth and in spirit. And the Bible says, the time has come where the true worshippers who worship Him in truth and in the spirit. You can't worship in the spirit without being in truth.
That's it.
Christ says, I am the light, the way, and the word. So you can't have Christ. You are still mumufi. Mumufi. You can only have Christ and live in truth. Truth is not about putting on a suit and looking good. It's being pure of heart.
That's it.
Truth is not about going out, oh, my friends, it's Mudishani, Mashukeni, I'm a human of God. It's you being truth of your heart. Pure in your heart. Pure is not about fasting every day, speaking in tongues, re-be-be-be-be, ro-bo-bo-bo. It's the heart being connected to God. When they say purity, they are not talking about you being clean. Yes, cleanness is next to what? But it's not about being clean outside. It's inside. How do you clean the inside? It's not going to the hospital to clean your blood. It's spiritual. That is not my message. But I wanted to take you for you to understand that Thanksgiving is a place where you understand that the source is God, is Abba, and is above everything. Why don't you celebrate Him when He gives you? You start appreciating Him when you see that things are not okay. Let's thank God even before you receive what you are waiting for. Father, I thank You for the things that You have done and the things that You are yet to do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For the marriage that You are yet to receive. Thank Him to say, Father, I thank You because my marriage will be the best.
Mm.
No, Father, I thank you for you have given me a wonderful husband. Oh Lord, these demons are holding my husband. No, there's no demon. You have to introspect now. Hello? Someone is looking at me, Anna. I'm not talking about your husband, because there's no husband. There's school. Hallelujah. Look, before you succeed, thank God for your success. You say, Lord, I thank you because I am successful. I'm yet to receive my success. Don't wait for people to tell you that, can't you see that it's God? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thanksgiving, it's about recognizing the source. Who is the source? It's the center supply of everything. A source is not an outrunner. A source is where you start with everything. Hallelujah.